from a anatomic level, we know that patients, both in a pain state and in a depressive state, have hyperactivity in the anterior cingulate gyrus. This way, if we're able to target regions where there's functional connectivity and where there's anticorrelation, meaning if we upregulate certain areas of the brain and downregulate the anterior cingulate gyrus, we're able to get better outcomes. It is well known that patients who suffer from chronic neuropathic pain have a high comorbidity with major depressive disorder. In a pain clinic, a study looked at the amount of major depressive disorder. They found that there was 87% of their patients also met criteria for major depressive disorder. When treating patients for neuropathic pain with TMS, it is very useful to be able to precisely navigate towards the regions of interest. Specifically, you can treat two areas. If you look at the motor area, which can help with the physical aspects of pain, but you can also think about the dorsolateral prefrontal cortex and think about the emotional aspects of pain. In our clinic, we found that by treating both areas sequentially, you get better results. One amazing example of using TMS to treat chronic neuropathic pain is a patient we recently saw who had many years of refractory trigeminal neuralgia. Literally, after the first day of treatment, she started crying because this was the first time she was ever able to touch her face. For the years before that, every other time that something rubbed up against her face or touched her face, she was in tremendous pain. After one session of TMS, she was able to tolerate people touching her face. It was pretty dramatic to see.